prepared this morning, and I did it at the 7:30, which was very early for me, and I didn't read it because I was nervous. I wanted to make sure I was doing eye contact with everyone. Then I forgot to say a whole bunch of stuff, so I'm going to read it. So growing up, my name is Tami Larkan, and I've been a member for 16 years here at St. Mary's with my husband, Clint, and our three kids. And Father Christian asked me to speak today about why I give to St. Mary's. So I'd like to start by saying growing up, I attended St. Martin's in Jensen Beach, and our lives revolved around church. Everything, whether it was at church, church events, our church family, et cetera, everything sort of revolved around church. Giving of one's time, talent, and treasure takes place in many different forms. I consider the gift of my time as the greatest contribution that I have made and continue to make at St. Mary's. Over the last 16 years, I've played many roles here. I've hosted, planned, and coordinated dinners, events, and fundraisers. I've served on the Capital Campaign Stewardship Committee, and now I'm serving on the Rector Search Committee. Each of these opportunities introduces me to a new group of St. Marians, thereby growing my church family, one of the greatest gifts I've ever received. So when I talk about my church family, every time I serve on a committee or plan something, I get to know different people in the church. And so when I come here on Sundays, I really feel like I know people, and I love being a part of that. I love coming to church to drop something off, and I stop in the office, and I see my family, and I feel like I feel welcome, I feel valued, and I feel treasured. When I come to Mary's Closet to pick stuff up, it's like, oh, hey, hey, everybody, and I just love being a part of that. So if you ever need a pick-me-up, go to church. St. Mary's feeds me spiritually on Sundays at services, but it also gives me opportunities to grow my faith by working alongside other members who share the same passion to serve. When I'm planning, organizing, serving, and giving of my time with others here, I feel the presence of the Lord. And as Jesus says, whenever two or more are gathered in my name, there I am. But of all of the ways that I'm involved at St. Mary's, serving on the outreach committee has by far been the most rewarding. It is through outreach that I'm given opportunities to live out our mission of growing into Jesus and reaching out with love. Growing our relationship with the Monterey community has been one of the greatest and most rewarding experiences. I love going into the community to deliver items donated from Mary's Closet. The way the kids' faces light up when I pull up into their driveways makes my day. Our relationship with the community, the Monterey community, was very evident this year at Meet Me at the Manger. From Reverend Patsy sliding down the mountain with the children on her lap to the best street tacos ever cooked by the members of the Monterey community, one thing was evident: God was present. 2 weeks ago, Maureen Cotter talked about trading happiness for joy. This really resonated with me. Giving of my time is not always easy. It is a sacrifice, but it is also when I feel closest to Jesus, when I must stop and take a deep breath and remind myself that it is all for Him, because we are all called to be His hands and feet here on earth. I promise I already had that written down here before Christian said it. So, the answer to my question of why I give to St. Mary's is because St. Mary's gives to me. I have received so much more than I have given by giving the gift of my time to St. Mary's. And then I was just going to say, we have our outreach meeting today, so if you're sitting there wondering how you can get involved at St. Mary's, for me personally, outreach has been the most rewarding. And there's a meeting today right after church in Smith Hall, so you can come and find out how what our plans are for 2023 and how we are living out our mission of growing into Jesus and reaching out with love. Thank you.
All right, friends, and now we have a video to share from another one of our vibrant ministries here.
Scripture is filled with examples of transcending generosity, like the account in Exodus 36, where Moses had to ask the Israelites to stop offering their gold and silver to the building of the tabernacle in the wilderness because they donated more than was needed. Imagine donating more of your time, talent, and treasure to St. Mary's, like over 30 years of your life serving in our music ministry. Well, that's exactly what John Burson has done. He tells us why.
It's an excellent venue to learn new techniques and new vocal skills. We deliver what we feel is very meaningful music, and it's also very enriching on a personal level. I find we all do, I think, find it very emotionally and spiritually rewarding, enhancing, fulfilling, and all those adjectives come into play there. Because there is a lot of personal, spiritual growth that comes with working through this music and then delivering it to the congregation on Sunday mornings. And we have a heck of a lot of fun, too. It's a wonderful, wonderful group of people. We're all very close personally, and it's always been that way. That during my tenure, I've always felt that about our choir, is that we're just a very close group as well. So a lot of benefits, I think, from it.
John, does St. Mary's Music Ministry have an outreach?
We do. Brandon has created a tremendous music program, not only for Sunday mornings, but throughout the year for different events, luncheons, evening concerts. He's brought in outside talent. But in addition to those marvelous things, the choir has also done some outside work, if you will. We have sung for the Arts Council. We have sung for Patients in Hospice. We sang years ago for an event at Temple Beth Hayam. So we do get out as well as a group to perform. And I think through all of this, our choir has kind of become known as a bit of a respected choral group in Martin County. And I'm very proud to be a member of St. Mary's Choir. I really am.
Our transcending generosity of time, talent, and treasure changes our church to the glory of God and His kingdom. Please fill out your 2023 pledge card or pledge online by January 29th as we continue growing into Jesus and reaching out with love.
All right, cool. So, friends, let's get those pledge cards in, and we have them out on the welcome table. You can go online. It's really easy. Digitally, just do it. I think that's how I did it, and that's on there. And then next week, so we want to just bring it all to fruition, and we want to have God bless it all. So whether you've already turned them in or if you did it digitally, next week we're going to have these symbolic, offering cards. They're going to be very simple. They're going to be different, and that you are invited to, whether You're it doesn't matter if you're a member, non-member, part of stewardship, not part of stewardship, if you just showed up, you're offering to God for 2023. And think about that. What do you want to offer? Is it you want to offer your compassion? God, I have a lot of compassion. Help me to offer that. Is it what you want to offer your grief and say, God, let me just give you my grief, and what are you going to do with that? What's something beautiful you can make out of that? God will take anything you give him and make something beautiful if you offer to him truly. Or if you just want to say, God, I want to give you my money and do something really special with that. Write that down, and most importantly, we're going to call the Holy Spirit to bless us. That'll all be next week. But in the meantime, please get them in, and we want to do this so then you don't have to hear us talking about it, right? But it's a united front. We're united church, and we all got skin in the game here, literally. Okay, my friends, let's walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as an offering and a sacrifice to God.